Welcome to A Word from the Wise, the podcast from Solwise, where we talk about products, news, or anything that you might be interested in within the industry. We do these on Spotify, Amazon Music, or anywhere where you get your podcasts from. Or if you prefer to see us, you can scare yourself and go and watch us over on YouTube and enjoy today's podcast. Welcome to A Word from the Wise. It's been a while. We've had a couple of months off, haven't we? So what with one thing and another, but we're back to it. We've come today to talk about the MIMO-4 from Poynting. And I suppose the first question, Daniel, is this is obviously a new one and it obviously looks different than the MIMO-3, but what's the main difference between the MIMO-4 and the MIMO-3?
So obviously they have similar names, so you can tell they're similar. They are both antennas that are designed to be easy to mount on moving vehicles.
Yeah.
So that's things like camper vans, trucks and boats. They are marine graded. They've got an IP69K rating, so they're
very highly rated,
sturdy. The key differences, most easy to spot obviously, is that they have a different design. They're more shaped a bit like the puck antennas that Poynting also do.
Yeah, I suppose it's worth telling people who are listening that the MIMO-3 is the one that's the shark's antenna
shape, then
this one, as you say, looks like the standard puck antenna but is bigger.
It's like a bigger puck,
it's a much
antenna,
bigger version.
So it's got a lower profile than the MIMO-3 and it's smaller in terms of surface area, so it's a lot easier to find space for.
I think it's just neater looking.
And
that might just be a girl thing to say, but it's just a neater looking, prettier type of antenna, I suppose.
Aesthetics are important.
Indeed, yes.
But the size does give it, well, the shape specifically does give it other advantages, so it's got a lot of the puck's more versatile mounting options as well. So whereas the MIMO-3 could really just be spigot mounted, which wasn't always convenient or feasible, the MIMO-4, it's got a mounting bracket for wall mounting. It can go on a pole, horizontal or vertical. It's got the surface mounted tape on it, so it can just be stuck down. And there is also the option to buy a magnetic mount to go with it as well. So it's got a lot of different mounting options that make it suitable for not just going on vehicles, but also you could use it just on the side of a house just as well as
a conventional antenna. If you had a summer house or something like that, you could just put it on the side with this bracket and sit it on the...
Yeah,
that does make it extremely versatile, really, doesn't it?
And there are other differences as well, more technical differences. So they are similar in terms of performance. It's not like a vast performance improvement on the MIMO-3. It is slightly different and it's supposed to be slightly better in that regard. But the key technical difference is that it is much more future-proofed because it's covering the higher 5G frequency bands that aren't really currently used,
going up to
6,000 megahertz.
Yeah.
Whereas the MIMO-3 stops at, I think, 3,800. So it's, if you're looking for an antenna that you're not going to have to replace anytime soon at all and will be performing to the higher levels as the higher levels become available that aren't even available now, then this antenna is what you'd be looking at for that.
Which would make it really useful, certainly if you're going to put it in an awkward spot. So if you were going to put it on the roof of a house or if you were going to drill a hole in your motorhome, you don't want to be faffing about getting a new antenna in a year's time, then that does sound like a really sensible thing to do, doesn't it, really?
Yeah.
I suppose also worth noting that the one we have here if you're looking at this on the video, is the white one, but we do have black options as well. Now, also, there are a number of different options as well, isn't there? So this one is the MIMO 4-17, but there are other versions as well.
Yeah.
Can you tell us the difference between the different versions?
Yeah, so, I mean, starting with the 17, obviously, it's the 7-in-1 antenna, and you can tell because it's got 7 cables coming out the bottom of it for each of its 7 individual antennas that it has embedded within it.
And they're marked up as well, aren't they?
Yeah, they have markings on them, so you know which is which.
Yeah.
The Well, I suppose we'll start with the 5-in-1, or the MIMO, I think we have it, the MIMO 415, which is obviously the equivalent of the MIMO V315. So that has the two mobile antennas, two Wi-Fi antennas, and then one GPS. So we can use it to improve mobile performance to a mobile router or gateway. You can use it to improve Wi-Fi performance or grant Wi-Fi, like external Wi-Fi access to a router or something like that if you want to use it as a client. And obviously the GPS, that's if you've got some kind of GPS system and you want to improve the signal to that. The 7-in-1, which this is just a slight upgrade on that, where instead of having just the two mobile antennas, it's got four.
Yeah, so and they, as I say, they're colour-coded,
yeah.
So you could see. So the purple ones will be for LTE, I'm guessing, looking at this, because they don't have a label. They used to do a label, didn't they? But I think it's better this way. So you can see if you've got four, it's the four for the LTE, two for the green ones will be Wi-Fi.
I think it says their LTE on the side, so they do stop.
Oh, so it was well spotted, yeah. That's it was disguised. There we go. Yeah.
So it's got four LTE, and the advantage of 4/2, obviously, is that if you're using it with a proper 5G router or just a top-end 4G router, that's probably going to have four mobile connections on it because it can be 4x4 MIMO. Which is just double the performance of 2x2 MIMO.
So if you were going to pair something like this one up with a Teltonika router, something like the RUT X11, something like that would go with this one?
The RUT X11 has two mobile connections, so that's what you'd... If you had that, then you'd go with the 5-in-1.
Yeah.
If you had the RUT X14 or the RUT X50, they're both 4x4 MIMO.
Yeah.
So that's where you'd be looking at the 7-in-1, which this is. Or alternatively, so we discussed how this has the four LTE connections coming out of it, and also three more, two for Wi-Fi, one for GPS.
Yeah.
If you're not planning to use an outdoor antenna for Wi-Fi at all, and if you've got no particular plans to use GPS, and then maybe you don't want to basically pay the extra that you're paying to get those functions with the antenna, you can go with the MIMO 4-4 we have, which is the 4-in-1.
Right.
And that is just purely four mobile connections, LTE, no Wi-Fi or GPS. So if you're only really focused on getting a mobile antenna, then that's the one you go for, because then you're not paying for extra stuff that you're
not using.
And that's
a first for Poynting, because historically they always seem to have had the Wi-Fi option as well, haven't they? They don't seem to have always just done one that's just pure LTE. So I think that's a good move, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Certainly for the motorhome people, because it means you don't have a spare...
It means you pay a bit less and you don't have to deal with cables that are either dangling down or you have to tie
you can't get these... Because of the way that these are all put in this casing,
they
you can't get
out.
Rid of it, can you?
No,
so it's not like you can chop it off, for instance. Yeah. Oh, that's good.
If you did, you'd invalidate the warranty. So
oh, well, there is that. And then they do a 9-in-1. So what's the extra on that one?
So the 9-in-1, that is two extra Wi-Fi antennas.
Right,
so that's 4x4 LTE MIMO, 4x4 Wi-Fi, and then still the one GPS. And so that's just if you've got such a top-end router that not only does it have four mobile connections, it also has four Wi-Fi connections.
I don't think we're going to sell many of those, do you?
No, but they do have it as an option.
Yeah.
So it's obviously something that they estimate will become more, perhaps more common in the future.
You might find, I suppose, some of those high-end marine-type routers, Peplink ones, they are quite high-end like that, aren't they? So it might be something like that it would be ideal for.
Yeah. I don't think any of our Teltonika routers are at that level yet, though.
I don't think so, no. So what sort of scenarios do you see? I mean, we've referenced putting them on motorhomes and so on, but is there anywhere specific you think that these would work best?
Yeah. Obviously, the main purpose of them, the idea they have is that most of the people that get these will be using them on vehicles, like camper vans and that kind of thing.
But you could have them, I suppose, on a bus, couldn't you?
You could have them...
Or a lorry?
Anything, yeah, that... As I said, they're a lot more versatile than the MIMO 3s, where they're so easy to mount and a lot smaller. So, yeah, feasibly, anything that you want to have some kind of mobile signal on a network, buses, trucks, stuff like that, yeah, you can fit them on anywhere. And as long as you've got a router for them to go into, then they'll work. As I said, they're highly rated, so they're not going to be... there's not going to be any way you can't put them because they'll be damaged or anything like that. They're IP69K, so.
Yeah, so what does IP69K then, just for listeners?
It's just a really high IP rating, so I can't tell you what all the different classifications are, but the stronger the IP rating is, the better it'll
do. Yeah, it's to do with dust and water, isn't it?
Dust and water
resistance. IP68 is probably the one that most people will be familiar with, that we've talked about before, for marine grade type thing. IP67 is your outdoor Wi-Fi devices we do, like the Ingenious stuff. They're all IP67, aren't they? So this is the next bit of probably something more to do with salt spray and
yeah, so as these can go out on the open ocean if needed, and those should still be fine.
Yeah. So what's good about them being MIMO? So what does MIMO mean? So that's multi-in, multi-out, isn't it? What does that mean? So what's so good about that?
That is good because it means you can have simultaneous data transmissions going in and out at the same time. So data isn't crashing into itself. It's not creating like any kind of traffic jam. And it just means faster overall throughput for downloads and uploads.
So this is your new favourite antenna then, is it?
It's a good one, yeah. I like recommending it more than the MIMO-3 because I just know that it'll be easier to mount.
Well, yeah, sometimes it just makes life easier, doesn't it? So if there's plenty of mounting options in the box, it saves people having to faff about choosing just optional this and optional that. It's just, you can say, this does everything that you need it to do.
Yeah,
that's exactly what we need, isn't it? Dead straightforward. Excellent. Is there anything else you'd like to add? I feel this is going to be quite a quick video because we like it. It's good. It's reasonably priced. Good quality. I don't know there's much else more to say, is there really?
I don't think so, no. We've said all the different ones that we do.
Yeah.
That's about it, I think.
Excellent. All right. Well, thank you very much for tuning in for our very quick podcast this month. We'll see you next month. Thank you very much.
Bye.
Thank you for either watching or listening to today's podcast. If you've got any ideas, pop us an email over to sales@solwise.co.uk, and we will see you next time.